Hi and welcome back to How to BIM. In this video, I'm going to show you how to download, install, and activate Revit 2025 for free. So it's been a while since I created videos in this channel because I've been a little busy, but the new Revit being out is a good opportunity to get back, so let's get started. So the first thing to do is typing autodesk.com in your browser. Well, first I'm gonna log out of my account so I can show you how to create an educational account so you can get Revit 2025 for free. So we're gonna click on a download free trial and go to education, educational community. It will take me straight to my personal account. So I will sign out and show you how to create your own account. Okay, so we will go to get started. First, you will enter your email, then accept the conditions, then write your full name, first name, last name, and then go to educational role and select whether you're a student, educator, etc., and state your date of birth. Next, press and continue and go to your school info. So first, you're gonna state the country of your school, the country that you're studying in. Then the address of your school, the city, the postal code, and then your school information, whether it's a university or a high school. Then the name of your educational institution and the website, obviously. Then your enrollment information, including your graduation date. And then agree that this information is accurate and matches the identification provided by my school, and press on continue. Next, we will pass to the documents that you could send to Autodesk, including your school transcript, which should include your full name, your school name, and the date. It could be a school-issued confirmation letter, which should have your full name, whether you're a student or a faculty member, the name of the school, and the date. And the last option is a school ID, which is what I usually use, which is an ID badge with full name of the student or the faculty member, obviously. It should have your school name and the date. The photo should be there, but it's not important. You should take a picture of these documents or scan them, whichever suits you, and send them for the submission of your document, which will result in you getting a subscription for a 1-year educational access. And the Autodesk team usually replies within 24 hours, and they will reach out to you if there's anything missing or if they need another document. But in my case, it's usually a very simple and a seamless process. So getting back to Autodesk, always choose the web install option, because it's always better than downloading the files and risking missing any files during the download. It wouldn't take a long time. The process is quite fast and secure, so there's nothing to worry about. Actually, the installation process of Revit when you have an educational account is so much better than previous versions like 2017 or 2018, etc. Now go to your download and execute as the administrator. Wait for a while. Choose the placement of your installation. And wait for a while as Revit 2025 installs. If this is your first time using Revit 2025, I wouldn't recommend that for you. But if you've used previous versions and you want to get more advanced in Revit or in modeling in general, I would recommend the playlist linked in the top right of the screen. It's about Dynamo, which is a feature in Revit that would help you visually code a lot of modeling tasks. So that would save you a lot of time, a lot of energy, and it's one of the softwares that are really in demand in the AEC market right now. So I would really recommend you start with this course linked above. Now, once Revit is installed, we'll check it around. So my system is in French, so it ended up in Revit being in French, so I have to close it and change the language. Right click, go to properties, and scroll to the side, delete FRA or whichever language you're using and change it with ENG, apply, OK. Then launch Revit again. It should be in English right now. Yes, it is. So let's open Revit. I like the fact that my Revit 2024 was in dark mode, and this one is automatically in dark mode. I really appreciate that. So the default project or the visualization project is the same as SnowDon, I guess it was called SnowDon or SnowDon. It's the same project as a Revit 2024. You can check it around just to understand and get used to the platform if you haven't used 2024. Because 2024 and 2025 are quite similar, as far as I've heard. So yes, let's play around with texture and shades. I'm really excited to discover and explore the new features. I think the next video will mainly be about the top features, and then I will try to create one video for the features that I like the most and that I think that are making an actual difference compared to the previous versions. So yes, that's it for today's video. Thank you for watching, and I hope it was helpful if you are having any issues downloading the software or activating it or getting an educational license, etc. You can check around the rest of my videos in my channel about Navisworks, Revit, Dynamo, etc. And yeah, thanks for watching again.